Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's Peter here from Total Blessings, and we are back again with a very interesting and educative video. So please, if you have not subscribed to my channel, subscribe so that you cannot miss one of these informative videos about photography, videography, color grading, camera settings. Please hit the subscribe button so that you can support the channel and so that you can motivate us to make more informative videos for you. So guys, recently I was hired by this hotel by the name RM Hotel in Chuda, Mombasa, to do a commercial about the Deka. So commercial did not include about the hotel itself. Majorly the client wanted to see about the Deka in the hotel. So my work was to shoot the Deka. I was excited at first being invited. So we teamed up with my friend by the name of Jeff. It was a shoot that took one day. I was able to get the Eros and the Biros to use in the making of the commercial. So I was very excited. I spent quite a lot of time from 7 p.m. up to 1 a.m. in the night making it, but the video was ready in the morning. So guys, I wanted to guide you how to make such adverts, but we encountered some problems there, including the car we chose to shoot at. I tried even shooting in auto white balance, but that was very wrong. I did not get the good colors, but the good thing, I was able to do some corrections. So guys, for today, I wanted to mentor you how to do these good commercials, to do them effectively so that you can enhance good storytelling and then so that you can satisfy your client. This is my first time actually I'm doing such a good commercial. I felt good, it was a good trial. I know there are some shots I missed. Here are some tips that I thought I'd share with you so that in future when you are doing such projects, you can be able to be guided. And these are the do's and don'ts and the tips that you should include in the video. In some points, I may feel like I made some mistakes here and there, but the client was satisfied. But I know sometimes the client may be unable to judge, but I know you, fellow people who do this work, you can be able to judge. So tip number one that I wanted to share is the storytelling. Are you telling any story in that video? So our video, the client approached me and told me the video should be 1 minute or below 1 minute. So to my ability, I was able to cut with my friends. A friend called this photographer, you can check him on Instagram. We were able to check, he guided me which parts would be cool, which part don't make sense, which part made sense a lot, which part maybe there was the camera was shaking, the white balance was not correct, the color science was not correct. So I was able to correct it from when the time I approached him for assistance. My video was 1 minute 19 seconds, but I was able to cut it up to 15 seconds. So that's good. So the storytelling is that when you are doing the advert, many adverts even do last 15 seconds nowadays, but traditional adverts were lasting for 30 seconds. So in those 30 seconds or in those 15 minutes, are you selling any story? If there's an error or a mirror that you see that it's not necessary to be there, you can make sure that it's not there. For example, in my video, as you see here, guys, you know, in Mombasa it's known to be hot. So I wanted to show people or the potential clients will come to the hotel whether the hotel has an air conditioner or another fan. So there's a part here in the video, you see I included that fan. So while editing, I was there saying, I don't know whether the client will complain or not, but the client did not complain because how I shot it, it came out well. Though for me, in professionalism, I feel like it's not good to be there. So that's about storytelling. Make sure your video is telling a story, or maybe what you are shooting is flowing from A to Z. So the second thing that I want to share to you is you choose your frame rate well. Guys, there is this golden rule that you choose your frame rate well. Even though people who shoot with red cameras for those movies, they do shoot with the correct frame rate. So if you are shooting action or with a person speaking, I think it's good you choose 25 frames per second. So the second thing is about composition. Composition is what included in the image. In the image, I mean the whole video of what are you showing in the video. There is what I've said about the storytelling. So composition is what is good in the video. For example, in composition, you can see the background. Then I have decided which background to use, which are clothes to use in the background, whether it's white, blue or red. I have decided whether I want my PC full or half to be seen in the video. I've even decided not to expose my lights that are using two lights here. So choose your position where unwanted things, don't include them in the video because the viewers will be distracted. No one gonna visit that hotel or no one gonna pay attention to that. The third one is color science. The cameras we use, they have the limitation. Some of them don't shoot raw, some of them don't shoot raw. So when you are recording, there's some people who say that you record and then I go to edit. You see the white balance is wrong, I go to edit. So sometimes it's good to shoot to edit, but sometimes it's good to shoot for master. Shoot for master, even if you don't edit a lot, the image quality is okay. So even if you go to edit in a hurry, you'll be able to just make the cuts, make the audio settings, and then you are done. But if the image quality is very bad, you're supposed to go to change your white balance. I mentioned white balance, I think it's good to choose to do with auto white balance when you're recording, unless you are good at choosing. So for my camera, it has the option of setting your white balance. So for example, when I'm doing a portrait of people, and I'm using this light, and it's an indoor press, it's cool press. For example, in shadows, I do use 5500K. So I think if you are good to choose, I think you can choose. But in hotel, the problem was there were some yellow lights, brown lights, other blue lights, green lights. So I was unable to actually choose. So at that point, you leave your camera to choose the correct white balance because you have many lights and many sources of light. So for that point is to choose your shutter. I think for my video, I used, even if I was going down, because there are some points where I was unable to carry my lights, maybe because of the space. There's a point I went to 1/50 and show you, but I look at that image and saw it was not very sharp. So again, choose your f number, where the aperture. Mostly I used an aperture of 2.8, so I did not go below 2.8 because I wanted the image to be very crispy clear. So I think color science, choose your white balance very well. So even if you have used, for example, in some points I used this white balance of K, and then I looked at the overall image. The overall image was too brown. So I went to edit in Adobe Premiere Pro, and then I hit the mask icon for white balance, and then I clicked in the image, and the computer was able to set it well. But at some point, the computer is not able to set the exact white balance. So you're supposed to adjust the tint and the temperature. Vibrance enhances when you're color grading. If you pull the vibrance up, the vibrance will raise the overall colors in that image. So I think it's good when you are shooting, shoot something that customers will be able to read very well. In terms of, maybe don't be too complex with the rows, don't over put many transitions, just put simple transition, because customers are only interested to see the space. Customers who want to book for events, for photography, or for maybe to do some YouTube vlogs there, they only want to see the space and the decor. Then the other one is the AROS and the BROS. The AROS is the overall picture. Maybe you record with a wide lens of you entering to the hotel, what you expect. So the other one is lighting the image quality. So the problem we had, I used my softbox, I attached a lighting at the back. But the problem, I don't have a battery for that light, so I use electricity. So there's some points that were very dark, so that's the point that I took advantage and used the lighting. But the overall hotel had good lighting. But the disadvantage that light, some light were brown, some were green, so choosing my white balance was very complex. But I managed to choose my white balance well, and I used the advantage of that hotel lighting. Then the other one I have talked about is editing. Choose the correct format of the audio. Don't choose an audio that will put the current at risk. Some audios are very good, but they have this disadvantage of the copyright issues. You don't know whether the client will post that video to. Even nowadays in Instagram, when you are posting video news, or in TikTok, they do say that the audio is not licensed in your area or in your country. So it's good to choose the good audio, even have a cinematic audio sometimes, because it will sell your product. So guys, please subscribe if you have not subscribed. See you on the next video. Peace out.